College football is a game played on a regulation field with 11 players starting for one team and 11 for the other. At Texas, it is. It is playing before the largest home crowds in the southern United States. It is attending one of the nation's highest-ranking educational institutions. It is being a part of an athletics program with the nation's finest facilities, like a $6.5 million swimming facility, a Major League-style baseball field for the national champions, and a 17,000-seat special event center for basketball. It is living in Austin, the state's capital, and sharing the beauty of the lakes and Texas hill country. But most of all, it is being a part of winning. Under the guidance of Athletics Director Darrell Royal and Assistant Director Bill Ellington, Texas has won 6 national team championships in the last 12 years. It is a rugged tradition that is as much a part of Texas football as it is a proud heritage of a beautiful land and city. Texas has not lost in this massive stadium since 1967. And this season's Southwest Conference Championship was the 7th for the Longhorns in the last 8 years. The league crown was Texas' 20th and Darrell Royal's 11th in his 19 years as head coach of the Longhorns. His teams have won 178 games in a brilliant 22-year coaching career, ranking him 3rd among active coaches. Only Bear Bryant and Woody Hayes have won more games. Darrell Royal has taken Texas teams to 16 bowl games in 19 years. The Longhorns finished 3 on the various All-American teams, quarterback Marty Akins, fullback Earl Campbell, and tackle Bob Simmons. Royal has had 22 All-Americans at Texas. The Longhorns had a dozen players selected as All-Southwest Conference. As recruiting coordinator Ken Dabb says, winning and a good education, that's a tradition at Texas. 1975 season opens at Memorial Stadium, Texas against Colorado State. Graylin Wyatt begins a Texas drive with a 17-yard run behind an Earl Campbell fake. Campbell, behind blocks by Charles Wilcox and Bob Simmons, breaks through a huge hole and goes 15 yards for the first Longhorn touchdown. After recovering a Colorado State fumble, Texas scores again on this perfectly timed pitch from Marty Akins to Jimmy Walker to make the score 13-0. Here's Earl Campbell again. The Tyler Rose breaks over the right, pulls away from two people, and breaks into the open for 46 yards. With Walker running shotgun. Don Brough coaches the Texas offensive backs. Akins goes for 14 yards on the option right. And the senior quarterback gets a touchdown on this 2-yard run. Early in the second quarter, Colorado State has a drive stopped by this Raymond Claiborne interception. Lionel Johnson and Brad Sherry hit the ball carrier, and Fred Sarche recovers for Texas at the Ram 36. 6 plays later, Akins makes it 25-0 on this 9-yard scamper behind Campbell. Landry Miner scores on this end-around play, the split end going 17 yards for the TD. Penalty wipes it out, but here's Earl Campbell on a 75-yard touchdown run. Let's watch it just for fun. Here Lionel Johnson steals another Colorado pass and runs it back 39 yards. David McWilliams coaches the Longhorn linebackers. Late in the game, freshman quarterback Ted Constanzo is in the game. He pitches wide to Robert Butler, who runs for 25 yards. Constanzo gets a score on this 5-yard run. Alfred Jackson is on the receiving end of this 19-yard Constanzo pass. Prentice Williams coaches the wide receivers. And the split end gets the final touchdown on this 25-yard end-around play. Texas wins it 46-0. Texas travels northwest to play the Washington Huskies in Seattle. Trailing 3-0, Texas' Earl Campbell breaks for 12 here in the second quarter. Braylon Wyatt goes for 16. And Wyatt scores the first touchdown on this 2-yard in run. Lightning strikes quickly midway through the second period as Campbell breaks over the right side and dashes 61 yards through the shadows for a touchdown. Texas 14, Washington 3. Texas heads for another touchdown as Wyatt breaks over the right side for 21 yards. On the next play, Campbell goes in for the two to make the score 21-10. On the first play of the fourth quarter, Fred Sauché stops a Husky drive with his pass interception. Tim Doerr coaches the UT defensive backs. Akins goes for 30 on this keeper. Akins is one of three captains for the 75 Longhorns. Sauché and Bob Simmons are the others. Earl Campbell gets Texas' final touchdown on the smash over center. The final score, Texas 28, Washington 10. The Longhorns return to Memorial Stadium to face Texas Tech in a Southwest Conference game. Rick Fidlaw recovers this Raider fumble for the Longhorns. Here's Akins on one of his patented pitches. This time to Jimmy Walker for 16 yards. Walker gets a block. Akins gets the score for 7. Akins on a keeper left. He wins a race to the goal line for a 7-0 Longhorn lead. Later in the first period, Akins passes 12 yards to Landry Miner. Here the Texas quarterback passes 10 yards to Walker. Akins was 7 of 10 in the passing department against Tech. Earl Campbell goes 20 yards for the score, jumping over one Raider at the 2. Jim Gresham hits a Tech quarterback, then gets up to hit the pitch man for a 2-yard loss. R.M. Patterson coaches the front four on defense. Akins on a keeper left runs for 21 yards. Jackson provides a good downfield block. Wyatt, with a late pitch from Akins, scores on this 17-yard run. Linebacker Bill Hamilton strips the ball loose, and Chris McDaniel recovers for UT. Campbell shows his splendid balance on this 30-yard run to give Texas a 29-0 lead late in the third period. Freshman Johnny Jones of Hamlin goes 25 yards on this run. The speedster breaks several tackles before he was knocked out of bounds. Akins finishes the drive with this 8-yard scoring pass to tight end Joe Samford. Halfback Raymond Claiborne stops another Raider threat with this interception. And a 21-yard run back. Texas won the Southwest Conference opener 42-18. Utah State comes to Memorial Stadium. Earl Campbell greets him on this 40-yard touchdown run with good blocks by Charlie Wilcox and Bob Simmons. Willie Zappalike coaches the Longhorn offensive line. Texas safety Steve Collier recovers his Utah fumble to set up another touchdown. Here's Ed Akins pitch again. This time to Graylin Wyatt for a 5-yard TD run. Akins goes 39 yards on this one. The Longhorns are about to make it 21-0 in the first quarter. Jackson takes his Akins pass for 13 yards. And then the Longhorn quarterback scores on a 6-yard run. Brad Shera sacks the Utah State quarterback. Constanzo is at the controls now, and he passes to Jackson for this 29-yard TD play. Late in the second period, Constanzo hits Tommy Ingram on this 17-yard gainer. Constanzo gets a touchdown to make the score 35-7 at halftime. Collier intercepts this Utah State pass just before the half. And returns it 48 yards. The Texas defense is coached by Mike Campbell, assistant head coach in charge of defense. The Longhorns went on to a 61-7 victory, using reserves liberally in the second half. The Oklahoma game in Dallas. Texas trails 10-0 in the second quarter. Earl Campbell picks up 13 yards at the middle. Six plays later, Akins passes 38 yards to Alfred Jackson for a Longhorn touchdown. Midway through the third quarter, halfback Joe Washington scores on this 9-yard run to give the Sooners a 17-7 lead. The last play of the period, Joe Bob Bazell puts the rush on the Sooner kicker. Sauchet returns at 13 yards to put Texas in business at the OU 37. Akins for a 10-yard gain. Three plays later, Akins pitches to Walker on this 25-yard scoring run. Oklahoma is moving here, but Brad Shera knocks the ball loose, and Jim Gresham recovers for Texas at the Sooner 35-yard line. Akins drives the Longhorns to a tying field goal on this 6-yard pass to Jackson. Russell Erchleben ties the game at 17-all with a 43-yard field goal. Oklahoma won the hard-fought game 24-17 on this run by Horace Ivory. Texas is playing Arkansas at Fayetteville on television. After a scoreless first quarter, Bill Hamilton recovers a fumble. Start a Longhorn scoring drive. Camel hits the right side for 6. A few plays later, Akins scores on this 1-yard keeper. Texas takes a 10-0 lead into halftime on Erchleben's 27-yard field goal. Here, Akins sets up the three-pointer with two passes to Jackson, one for 29 yards, and this one for 10. Tackle Brad Shera intercepts an Arkansas pass midway of the third period. And two plays later, Graylin Wyatt scores on this 31-yard run to give the Longhorns a 17-3 lead. Later in the third quarter, Scherer recovers this fumble. And Akins starts out on another drive with this 55-yard run around left end. Same drive, fourth quarter now, as Akins finds Jackson on this 33-yard pass. Camel scores from the two, and Texas leads 24-3. The remainder of the fourth quarter saw the ball turning over several times. Here, Steve Collier stops one Arkansas drive with this pass interception. Texas won it 24-18. The Rice Owls come to Austin and they bring rain to Memorial Stadium. Texas opened its first scoring drive on this Graylin Wyatt run for 6 yards. On the next play, Camel draws a big crowd of tacklers, but Wyatt has the ball and scores on this 9-yard run. Later in the first period, Camel gains 12. Three plays later, Wyatt scores again on this pitch from Marty Akins. Texas begins another touchdown march on this Akins to Jackson pass for 43 big yards. With a little help from the official. Akins decides to run here and gains 7. On the next play, Wyatt gets his third tally of the game on this 8-yard dash. Rice is driving late in the half, but Bill Hamilton stops the threat with this line drive interception and sets up another UT score. Camel breaks over the middle on the triple option for 20. Walker scores on this pitch to the left, with Jackson providing a good block. It's 27-3 at halftime. In the third period, Akins runs for 44 yards. He fumbles, but Ivy Suber recovers for UT. 2 plays later, Suber scores on his 13-yard run down the sideline. Ted Constanzo hits Joe Abusi on this 41-yard scoring play. The Longhorns win it 41-9. Longhorns return to the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. Face the Mustangs of SMU. Texas trails SMU 7-0 in the first quarter when Raymond Claiborne breaks the kickoff for 52 big yards. Earl Campbell hits up the middle through a big gap, 33 yards. Then the Tyler sophomore scores a tying touchdown on this 2-yard smash. It's the middle of the second quarter now. Texas leads on Erchleben's 52-yard field goal. Campbell gets another drive going with this 11-yard gainer. Akins finds his roommate Alfred Jackson on this 11-yard pass play. Wyatt gains 12 on this pitch from Akins. Three plays later, Akins goes in from the Pony 3-yard line. Another Erksleben field goal, this one for 48 yards, gives Texas a 27 halftime lead. Late in the third quarter, Akins passes 21 yards to Jackson. Camel picks up 7. And the big fullback scores on this 5-yard smash up the middle. Paul Jett stops one Mustang drive with this pass interception. And the Longhorns win 30-22. Erksleben tied a school record with 3 field goals. It's Bevo's birthday at Memorial Stadium as Texas hosts Baylor's Bears. Texas trails Baylor 3-0 in the second period when Akins runs for 17 yards behind Earl Campbell. Akins gets another 6. Walker picks up 5. And Camel gets the go-ahead touchdown on this 5-yard run. Baylor is driving late in the half when Bill Hamilton steals this pass, the Longhorn goal. Tim Campbell sets up a Texas score with this fumble recovery. Big brother Earl then scores on this 21-yard run as he strews tacklers all over the lot. Halfway through the third quarter, Akins starts a drive with this 17-yard pass to tight end Joe Samford. Wyatt gains 14 on one of Akins' specialties as Walker blocks. Akins scores on this 14-yard run, aided by blocks by Will Wilcox and David Stutter. Spike Dykes helps coach the offensive line. Walker scores Texas' final touchdown early in the fourth quarter on this 5-yard run. The Longhorns win 37-21. TCU comes to town next. Longhorns open the TCU game with this 9-yard run by Wyatt. Campbell leaps over a hole at the left and picks up 14. Walker scores on this 20-yard run after taking an Akins pitch. On the next possession, Akins breaks tackles on this 24-yard run. Then Wyatt picks up another 24 with Walker blocking. And Campbell makes it 14-0 with this 7-yard scoring play. Freshman Tim Campbell, Earl's little brother, had 5 sacks in the TCU game. Here's one on the TCU passer for a 9-yard loss. And another by Tim Campbell. Sarche tips the ball. Paul Jett intercepts in second quarter action. Texas leads 14-3 in the third period when Tim Campbell causes this fumble and Brad Scherer recovers for the Longhorns. Erksleben kicked 2 field goals to give the Longhorns a 20-3 lead as Ten Campbell gets another sack, this one for 10-yard loss. Constanzo is quarterbacking for the injured Marty Akins. Here the freshman signal caller passes to Jackson for 43 big yards. That play sets up this touchdown run of 14 yards by Wyatt early in the fourth. Walker and Jackson help clear the way to a 27-3 lead. Raymond Claiborne turns in a fine defensive play with this breakup of a TCU pass. And Claiborne does it again as the Longhorns win their sixth Southwest Conference victory, 27-11. It's another big shootout, this time at Kyle Field in College Station, when number 2, ranked A&M, meets number 5, ranked Texas. The Aggies led the nation in defense, while Texas had the country's highest scoring team. Claiborne returned this kickoff 41 yards as the Longhorns trailed A&M 3-0. But a fumble stopped the drive at the Aggie 17. A&M goes out front 10-0 on this pass from Mike Jay to Richard Osborne. The Longhorns get back in the game in the second quarter on this 64-yard punt return by Raymond Claiborne. Some fine blocking in there. The half ended with that 10-7 Aggie lead in a bruising defensive game. Tim Campbell gives the Longhorns hope with this fumble-causing tackle. Brad Scherer recovers for UT at the A&M 36, but the stubborn Aggie defense prevailed and the third period ended still 10-7. A&M goes ahead 17-7 on this one-yard touchdown run by fullback George Woodard. Freshman Ted Constanzo is in for the injured Marty Akins and starts Texas back with this 36-yard pass to Alfred Jackson. Then he hits Jackson for 11 more. The Longhorns had to settle for a 47-yard field goal by Erksleben. The Longhorns make a great goal line stand from their own one-yard line late in the game. Woodard is stopped for no gain. Same runner, same result. Here Bubba Bean loses a yard on this jarring tackle by freshman back Glenn Blackwood. The Aggies settle for a field goal that gives him a 20-10 victory. Their share of the conference title earned the Horns a shot at Colorado in the 1975 Astro Bluebonnet Bowl. Colorado's taken a 14-0 lead and is driving as Lionel Johnson intercepts this Buffalo pass and returns it 22 yards. Earl Campbell takes an option pitch around right end and gains 10 yards. Marty Akins passes to Johnny Jones in the left flat for 30 yards. It's Marty again. This time to Alfred Jackson for 21 yards and a touchdown as the Longhorns close a gap to 14-7. We're in the second half now. Colorado fumbles and Bill Hamilton recovers for Texas at the Buffalo 34-yard line. All-American Earl Campbell takes a pitch from Akins and gets 12 yards. Then Jimmy Walker goes in untouched from the 2. Here's a big play of the day. Tim Campbell, the game's most valuable defensive player, with a great rush, blocks a Colorado punt, then recovers the ball in the end zone for a Longhorn touchdown. Texas goes for a two-point conversion. Marty Akins passes to Earl Campbell. Good, and the score is knotted at 21-21. Following another fumble recovery, the Texas offense stalls, and Russ Erksleben tries a field goal from 55. Texas goes for a two-point conversion. Marty Akins passes to Earl Campbell.
Player.
With a great rush, blocks a Colorado punt, then recovers the ball in the end zone for a Longhorn touchdown. Texas goes for a two-point conversion. Marty Akins passes to Earl Campbell. Good, and the score is knotted at 21-21. Following another fumble recovery, the Texas offense stalls, and Russ Erksleben tries a field goal from 55 yards out. It's good, and Texas leads for the first time in the game, 24-21. The Horns get good field position after Colorado quick kick. Akins passes to Jackson for 10 yards. Then Earl Campbell, the game's most valuable offensive player, powers off tackle for 17 big yards. And Johnny Jones gets a TD with this 4-yard burst over left tackle. Colorado is driving again. But Bill Hamilton erases the threat with this sack and 13-yard loss on the Buffalo quarterback. And it's Hamilton again. This time he intercepts a pass and returns it 14 yards. Earl Campbell behind great blocking goes for 9 yards and a Longhorn first down. Then Ivy Suber, on a pitch from Akins, gets the clincher from 7 yards out, and Texas wins 38-21. A great come-from-behind victory in the nationally televised Blue Bonnet Bowl, and a fitting climax to another successful Texas season.